Hello and welcome. Today we would just look at how we will enter into the new learning platform. Over the last few months, we were working our learning materials and watching it and listening to our lectures on a platform called VizIQ. But now, for certain reasons, we have changed into a new platform, and this is how that platform is going to work. And please listen carefully and see as the screen goes in and see the steps how we enter into this new platform as you watch. The URL that you must type is elearning.ipcseminary.com, and once you type this URL and you are led to the opening page of the learning platform. This is the opening page of the learning platform, and here you type your username, which we have already provided in our email to you. So here I am typing my username, which is my email, and I also will type my password. Once this password is typed in, and you are led into the home page of the student account in the learning platform. Once you enter the username and password, you will be led to your home page. This is how your home page will look like. On the top, you will see the name of the online education center with its logo as well, and your name here logged in as a student. And here you will see a message symbol over here, and there's a drop down menu over here. You have a command here for logout, and there's a place for resetting the password, and then there are something where you can edit your profile, and this is a progress report over here. And once you go down, you will see announcements over here. If the teacher is making some announcement concerning the class, it will be appearing here. So if you click here, this will be shown. And currently there are no announcement for the student, so we just go back. And then this is where you will see your courses. It said that my courses first. Actually, when you say first, it's referring to the first term. So you will see the first subject here, and you will see a small box over here with the name go to class. Once you click over here, you will be led to the course home page, and the name of the course is here. It's called Study Skills, and this is the welcome announcement from the teacher. This is a quite long one, and the teacher has signed in here. This will be basically instructions for the student how to go about the course and how the course will be designed, and what the student is expected to do in the course, and how the assignments are designed, on all those normal things which you would like to know about the course. And on the left hand side, you will have course information, and when you go to the course information, this is a place where you will see the description of the course, and if you have a syllabus, and this is a place the syllabus will be uploaded as well, and you will see the course outline and how the chapters are progressing. All those things, these details you will find in course information. And the next tab is the discussion tab. This is a place if the teacher wants you to maybe initiate a particular discussion after listening to a lecture or after reading a particular piece of material. If the teacher wants you to initiate a discussion, the teacher will create a thread over here. You can see here chapter 1 introduction, which it's a hyperlink, and once you click on this hyperlink, this thread will be opened, and then you can click on this new thread and post your comments over here. What the teacher wants to tell you is over here. For example, it is written over here. So this is the lead through which the teacher expects the student to just think or reflect or whatever he wants you to do, and do that, and click here on the new thread, and you can start typing here whatever you want to post here, and click on create, and that will be added into the new thread. And you can also post a title over here. Since this is only a demonstration, we will go back to the previous menu. And once you go back, you will see that this teacher has posted several hyperlinks over here, expecting his students to initiate discussion on each chapter. You can see chapter 1, chapter 2, it goes on to till chapter 8. And then the next tab, and on the left hand side, you will see the videos tab over here. Once you click on here, you will see the videos here. The introduction will be here, and this is the first video. Once you click on the video here, and you will see a small drop down menu, a video window opening up. This is a private video. You must log in here. Once you click in, you will be led to the login page of Vimeo. And since we have already provided the username and password for Vimeo, this is the place where you need to log in the Vimeo username and password. Once you log in into Vimeo, you will be permitted to watch this video, and otherwise it is not. And this is the second video. This is also a private video, and some videos are not private because they are linked to the public domain, such as this video you see here. And it does not have a password, it's not protected, so if you click it, it'll just open as it is. So similarly, you will see a long list over here. These are all various chapters, and each chapters will be having different videos under this. These videos are posted over here. These videos correspond to the class files here, and where the material that is corresponding to each of this video will be posted in this class files. We will quickly go to the class file section. You will see the same name of those titles given to the videos appearing here as well. Okay, each of these threads or these hyperlinks, once you click, you will see there is a material uploaded by the teacher over here. You will see a hyperlink here. Once you click on this, this material will be downloaded into your computer. These are downloadable materials. And one more thing about the videos, what I would like to tell you is that the private videos which are posted in Vimeo are not downloadable. You can view it any number of times, but they are not downloadable. But the videos on the public domain, they are downloadable, and you can view it perhaps on YouTube or Vimeo according to your convenience. These things are already mentioned in the course homepage in the welcome introductory informations and instructions which the teacher has already provided. So in the class files, you look at, and you will see class files arranged according to the folders. These are all, each of these correspond to different chapters, and once you click on these links, those materials pertaining to that chapter will be included there, and you will be able to download it, read it, reflect it. And once you are able to reflect it on, go to this discussion page, and where you will see the corresponding chapter will be also added here, where you are expected to initiate a discussion, post your reflection, post your comments there in the thread, which I have already explained. And these comments which you are posting as thread in the discussion session can be viewed by fellow students in your own class, and they can also participate in the discussion. And maybe perhaps towards the end, the teacher also will come and participate in the discussion as well. So after going to, I think the discussion part is clear, videos are clear. Going to quizzes, the next is the section on quizzes. And if the teacher has uploaded a quiz for you on this subject. This will be appearing in this section, and it will be asking section will be requesting you to take the quiz here. And this teacher has not uploaded any quiz, so nothing appears here. It's blank over here. And class file we already finished, and we go to submissions, and this is a place where you can turn in your assignments. If the teacher has already asked for a submission, that will appear here. There's a place where you can just insert your file. It's a place where you can upload your file. If you click on that the button, and it will be leading you to a place where you can choose your file, and your file will be uploaded. And there's also a place where this file will be corrected by the teacher, and the file will be returned with grades. And the next section on the tab side is a grade. And once you go to the grade, you can see the grade over here. And this teacher, since not given any grade, it shows that the final grade not submitted. And if the instructor has some comments over here, the instructor's comments also will appear here as well. And the last tab is the student list. Your name will be appearing over here with your the email, which is your username. And if any other students are there, fellow students are there in your class, also their names with the email and phone number, if you updated, it will be appearing over there. And if the student wishes to contact the teacher, here there is an option where you can click on the message. You can see there's a small round icon over here with the picture of an envelope. And once you click on this envelope, there's a place where you can type in the message. Once you compose new message, you can just send it to the teacher. It will be going to the teacher, and teacher also can send a message back to you as well. And this will be here, this message will be adding in your inbox. And you can look at this icon, whether if there's any message, it'll be showing over here. Now it's zero. That shows that there are no messages in the inbox. Completing all this, we go back to our home page. Before we go back, we will look at the phone numbers mentioned over here. You will see the phone number of the online office of IPC Theological Seminary, and this phone number will be active during the office hours, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Indian Standard Time. And also you will have the director's personal phone number over here. If you face some issues, you can write to us to our email, and this is the phone number. And if there is something very urgent issues that it needs to be addressed, you can also talk to the director. So once you finish this one, you are back to the home page. And this is your home page again. And there is a place where you have an option for registering for new courses. When the new course announcements are available, and you can register here, and you will be sent to the enrollment page, and the online office will be approving your enrollment. Only then here this box will appear, go to class. Once your enrollment is approved, you will be allowed to go to class. So this is how it's all about. You can also choose another term over here. Currently this subject is offered in first term. That's why you see here the expression first as here. So once this is all complete, and you can go back there, and you go there and you log out of your student account. This is all about the new platform. I hope it's more user friendly than the older platform, and more easier for you to approach. And we hope that you will find it interesting, and we pray that you will do better in your studies, and this platform will be a great help for you as well. Thank you.